Hello everyone and welcome to Simplify CCC, Microsoft PowerPoint training video series. In this video, we are going to study about setup slideshow. So let's see the content that we are going to cover in this session. So here we are going to study about what is slideshow tab and what are the contents it contain, what are the start slideshow means, and what is the setup for slideshow, and how we can record our slideshow. Yes, we can record our slideshow with MS PowerPoint. Let's see one by one. So it divides into three parts: start slideshow, setup and monitor. So let's see one by one. Very first group is this start slideshow that you can see at the image. The first option is a from beginning. If you want to start your slideshow at the beginning, you can choose for this. And from current slide, if you are working on some slide and you want to start the presentation from that slide, you can select this. Present online, it is for broadcasting. Custom slideshow that we can see when we go for our live preview. Next group is of our is setup group. It contains setup slideshow that have some option, and that we will see our live preview. It all have the options related to slideshow. Slideshow basically means the presentation. When presentation is going on, related to that, it contains the options and it contains the features that we will see. And it is the next option is the hide slide. We can hide this slide by this option. How we can hide this slide, we can see. Then we have the rehearse timing. We can rehearse timing to our presentation, that how much time we are taking to present a presentation. Next is our record slideshow. As I say that we can record our slideshow by this option, and we can also record our audio with our presentation. Let's see it one by one. Let's go to the live. So this is the presentation that we are working through. Just go to the slideshow tab. This is the slideshow tab, and you have see if the first group is the start slideshow. The first option is the from beginning. So when we click this, it will start our presentation from this slide. As we have we are on the third slide, but by pressing this, we will start our presentation from the beginning. Let's see. See, it starts our presentation from the very first slide. So it is used for that. And if you want that we present our slide, we start our slideshow from the slide we are working or we are currently open, then we go for from current slide. See, it is start from the it is started from the slide where we are working or we are open. Next is present online. It is for the broadcasting. As I already tell you about broadcasting, it performs a task like we provide our presentation at once to many. It is an advanced topic, so let it be now. And next is custom slideshow. So what is custom slideshow? It is very much similar to the topic you already studied section. It is work like this or work like that only, but there is a little bit of difference. Let's see. When we start the custom slideshow, it will open a dialog box with a new option enabled. Just click to new, and it will provide all of the name of the slides you are using. Just check those slides you want to add in a section. Let's take 1 to 5 as a one section and add to a custom show. We can change the name of the our custom show. Let's give it to introduction. As you click the OK. You can see here is the custom show is made with the introduction name. Here is the button show. You can show by using this. You can start your presentation and check whether the custom show as you required it made it or not. So just we are start. We have taking the first slide, second slide, third slide, fourth slide and fifth slide. After this it should stop. Okay, this is a stop. So our custom slideshow is made. If we want to start our custom slideshow, just go to the custom slideshow icon and it will at the top it will shows the name of your custom slideshow if you have any. If you want to delete that, just open it and select the option remove. It will remove your custom slideshow. Now you can see there is no slideshow. Okay, then next is our setup group. Setup group is for the setting up the slideshow. So it has the options regarding slideshow or time. So let us take it one by one. First one is the setup slideshow. As you click the option, it will open a dialog box with many of the options. Take it one by one. The first one is the presented by a speaker full screen. It is the default screen that we have already seen, that we have already when we OK and start our presentation, you can see this is the default screen. So next is the individual screen. When we check out this, it will provide our presentation with a title bar and a status bar. So by this you can work for another window or another software, and also your presentation is on moving mode. So this this can be used for that. And next group is this show options. Here you can see the option is loop continuously until escape. What does it mean? It means your presentation will be in running motion without any your mouse click or any enter click until you press the escape key. Let's take it live and see. See, it will move until in a loop. It will not going to break a loop. This is our last slide. If we enter, it should break. But as we set a loop, it will go in a loop and it will present. Presenting you in a loop until you press the escape button. As I press the escape button, it brings back to you. And next option is the show slides. If you want to show the all slides, you can go for this. If you want some particular slides to from 2 to you want to show the slides 2 to 5, you can go for this, and so on. And next option is the multiple monitor. We can let it be now because it is the advanced topic. So next option is our hide slide. How we can hide our slide and what does it mean? It means if we want to hide some slide, we want to hide from for now. Means we want in our presentation, but we don't want to in our slideshow. So if we take this slide, just choose the slide you want to hide and click this. Now you can see that it makes blur out this slide. And if we start our slideshow, it is not going to present our slide that we hide. See. It is not showing that presentation that we hide. If we want to remove from the hide property, just go and select that slide and again click this. Now we can see this slide in our presentation. Next is rehearse timing. Rehearse timing is used for recording the session time, recording the time that you spend on each slide while presenting your presentation. So for that, select the rehearse timing option. It will take to your presentation, and it will take the time, it will record the time for particular slide. And as you see, I change the slide, it start from the beginning, see, zero, and start again, and zero, and start again. Means it takes the slide, it take the time for each slide. And here we can see the slide of our total for our total presentation. Just yes, this. And if we want to check whether our times, like our rehearsal timing, is set or not, just start the slideshow. And you can see now it will move by itself without any clicking within the time that I decide, or we decide at the first timing. See, this is moving because we take the first time, first presentation, we have take too much time, that is why it takes. After that all, it will move back to your PowerPoint software. Here you can see it is a option given here, use time. Is if you uncheck this, then it will remove your rehearse timing that you record last. It will remove your rehearse timing, and if you start your slideshow, it will not moving according to your rehearse timing, your custom timing. You have to click, then only it will move. See, it will not move until I click. So I am going to click now. See, so this option is used when you don't want to use your rehearse timing. Next is record slideshow. It gives two options, either you can record with your current slide or with your beginning slide. So go for the beginning slide. Just you enter this and start recording. It will give you the recording part, and it will take the same technique that rehearse timing is taking. So what is the difference? What is the difference between the rehearse timing and the record slideshow? So rehearse timing and record time slideshow is the different because rehearse timing is the feature which record your time during the slide taking, each slide how much time is taken by each slide, it is recorded by rehearse timing. But by the record slideshow, you can record your audio with the time. This is the difference in the rehearse timing and record slideshow. You can also record the audio with the time in the record slideshow. As you see here, the narration or I should say here is the icon you can see, it shows that your audio is recorded with the slide. As you play or as you begin your slideshow, it will play automatically with the slide. If you want to hide this, you can uncheck the play narration option given here. As earlier you are hiding the time, rehearse timing, you can also hide the narration, narration or audio, I can say audio or play narration, you can hide the while if you don't want to represent it. Next is show media control. It is used for audio and video we are inserting, then to hide them or to show them. It is used in further videos when we are learning how to insert audio and video in our clips or in our slides. Then we come back to this topic and show this option. Next group is the monitor. it is the advanced topic for the broadcasting. So for now, let it be, and that's all about for the today's video. And I hope this video will help you. And if you like our video, you can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and Pinterest. Thank you.